President Obama pushing a plan to extend tax cuts for the middle class. In just a minute, we'll go live to Washington, D.C., where Kent Wainscott spoke exclusively to the president today. Now, the president is calling on Congress to extend the Bush-era tax cuts for another year. Americans who make less than $250,000 have been getting those cuts, but they're set to expire after the end of this year. Republicans want the breaks extended for everyone, not just the middle class. In 2010, President Obama said that he would not renew the cuts again, but now he says it's a move that he has to make to help the economy.
Many members of the other party believe that prosperity comes from the top down, so that if we spend trillions more on tax cuts for the wealthiest Americans, that will somehow unleash jobs and economic growth. I disagree.
If Congress does not pass the extension, more than 50 temporary tax breaks for individuals and businesses could be cut. Wisconsin Senator Alberta Darling criticizing the president's plan.
Senator Darling spoke to WISN 12 News this afternoon and said she believes the plan will amount to higher taxes to business owners.
This president is just totally out of touch with what the economy needs to get going. He's talking about taxing the job creators, the people who will actually help us grow the economy and help our middle-class families have jobs and be able to prosper and survive. It's really a very, very sad.
Senator Darling went on to say she believes Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney's plan to grow the economy will help him win in Wisconsin in November.
WISN 12 News was the only news organization in the state to speak to the president one-on-one today.
Kent Wainscott is live at the White House right now. Kent, you asked President Obama directly about the claims that his plan would hurt job creation.
Yeah, I did. We're standing on the north lawn of the White House right now. My one-on-one interview with the president took place in the West Wing in the Cabinet Room, which is just out of view off to my left here. But prior to that one-on-one interview, we attended that briefing in which the president made a very public call on Congress to extend those tax cuts for middle-class Americans, but not for the wealthy. And we spoke shortly after that, and I asked him about the criticism that not extending the tax cuts for the wealthy, the job creators, could lead to fewer jobs. You made the case today that everyone agrees that taxes shouldn't go up on the middle class, right. But you don't want to extend those tax breaks for wealthy Americans, right. And your critics say that's going to target job creators. You disagree with them, but how can you guarantee that there isn't going to be any impact on job creators that also then impacts the middle class?
Well, first of all, it's important to know that 97% of small businesses actually make $250,000 or less. So this is going to cover 97% of small businesses. And the way the tax code works, you've got about half of the 400 wealthiest Americans who technically qualify as small businesses and get tax breaks. So when folks talk about job creators, a lot of times they're just talking about some very wealthy individuals who aren't going around creating a lot of jobs but would save a lot in taxes. The important thing is that it would cost $1 trillion to extend taxes, tax cuts to folks like me. At a time when we're trying to bring down our deficits, that $1 trillion has to come from somewhere. So the question ends up being, would we rather spend that $1 trillion on providing tax breaks for small businesses that are hiring new workers, or providing young people some breaks on their student loans so that they don't come out of college with too much debt, or putting construction workers back to work, rebuilding our roads and our bridges? You know, what is it that we think that $1 trillion is more likely to do when it comes to job creation? And you know, I think the evidence is pretty clear that just giving more tax breaks to folks like me who don't need them, or half of the Fortune 400 wealthiest Americans, that's not going to be a good way for us to create jobs and middle class security.
Now, the president will press Congress on that, and he'll do it by going directly to the American people. But, you know, in this election year, some states carry more weight than others. And by inviting us here, by talking with us today, he is certainly trying to make the case that Wisconsin is an important battleground state. He's focusing on Wisconsin. So coming up at 6 o'clock, I ask him whether or not he believes he's doing enough to help Wisconsin manufacturers create jobs in places like Milwaukee and other Wisconsin communities, and also about campaigning in Wisconsin in the months ahead. We'll have that coming up at 6. For now, reporting live at the White House, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.